Have you ever heard of the Georgia power scam? Well, it's where someone calls you pretending to be from the power company and they claim you are about to be disconnected unless you pay up. Here's what happened when one of those callers tangled with our Better Call Harry.
If you're calling about a power outage, dangerous condition.
This sounds just like the Georgia Power main menu, but it's not.
Thank you for calling Georgia Power Disconnection Department. My name is Emily Rogers, for supervisor. How may I help you?
Hey, I'm calling about I got a notice about a past due bill.
It's a lady who wants my money. Apparently, CBS 46 News hasn't paid the electric bill.
They experienced a major power outage.
And she's shutting us down, like today.
CBS Atlanta?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it looks like we have a service disconnection scheduled for today because of non-payment on the account for the electric.
This scam never gets old. For decades, phony collectors targeted individuals, but then they switched to businesses. Back in 2016, our Vince Sims was there when this gym owner returned one of those scam calls.
89703, sir.
89703?
There's something about that 800 figure. Not too high, but not too low.
I show here the balance on the account is 874.54.
Well, that's not bad. That's like one day for us.
I don't think she gets it. But you know who does? The real people at Georgia Power. They hate these guys.
We're seeing this across the utility industry right now, which is why, you know, we're so proactive at telling our customers how we behave and what they can expect from us.
Georgia Power does not harass, and it certainly doesn't direct you to the nearest gas station.
Looks like I have a Citgo gas station on 605 North Avenue Northeast. They have a kiosk inside. So basically what you would need to do is once you get there, before making that payment, you would need to get in contact with my department so that myself or any other agent can help you process the payment correctly.
Georgia Power does have payment kiosks, but they don't require you to call them for instructions.
And so what's your position at Georgia Power?
I am the floor supervisor.
That's why, if you get the call, cross-check your balance with Georgia Power's website or call the number off their website direct.
You do know I'm calling from a TV station.
The same rules apply for emails. If you get one from Georgia Power or claiming to be from Georgia Power and they say you've got a balance, don't click on any links. Instead, go to Georgia Power's website. And if someone asks you to wire funds, it's a scam. The best way to reach me is email. Better call Harry at cbs46.com.